One minute he's helping out a neighbor in need, hours later, he's the one looking for help.
KMBC 9's Kelly Eckerman explains why a car break-in is heartbreaking for a local family.
This crime victim is a local college student who volunteers in the community. Now the tools he uses to do that work are gone, stolen from his car, and he and his family feel robbed of a whole lot more than that.
So I had all my tools right here, and they took them all, but they left my caulking guns.
There were a lot of tools stolen from James Crump's car trunk, power tools, hand tools, and a set of mechanics tools, not to mention damage to his car, parked in a driveway off this alley north of the plaza. And while a struggling college student can't afford any of this loss, it's the sentimental value he feels most robbed of. Those tools were handed down from his great-grandfather, who was a mechanic. All that family history now gone.
I won't be able to hand them down as I get older. And so they're just gone, and they're with someone who won't care about the story behind them or what future they have. All they care is about getting a couple dollars off of them, maybe.
He's proud of how he'd been putting those tools to use, like volunteering for the Christmas in October program.
James and his classmates had just finished rehabbing this deck and building these stairs for an elderly woman who lives here. And they were feeling so good about all they'd been able to accomplish. This was not the ending they had anticipated.
Well, you're not stealing from a car, you're stealing from a person. They're real people that, your victims, they're real people that, whether the tool is important to you or not, or whatever you steal, that it may be very important to the person that you're taking it from.
The tools were stolen sometime overnight Sunday. The car was parked near 43rd and Jarbo, and many of the hand tools were in a black toolbox with a silver diamond plate on the front.